All right, we have a new arrival today at Westport Auto Center. It's a 1969 Ford Mustang Grande, loaded up, loaded with equipment. Factory F code 302. Power disc brakes in the front, power steering, factory air. Just a nice driver. Older paint job, showing a few minor flaws, but still shows well. Original lime green car, that is what we have on it today. 69 with the dual headlights, gotta love that front end. Magnum 500s. It is a bucket seat car, floor counts up. No floor console, but a floor shifter. Please like and subscribe to our channel. Like and share the video. Just a nice driver. When we get back, you know, it basically has what you see in the Mach 1. No tack in the dash. It's showing 85,000 miles, but that's what's on the odometer. It does have the dash, the clock like the Mach 1. Does have AM, FM stereo, but the stereo barely coming in right now, so we'll have to see if we got maybe an antenna issue. Big change of difference in temperature. It's a 3-speed automatic. It does have the full spare tire iron and jack in the trunk. Straight, let go of the steering wheel, right down the road. Got good acceleration, but you know, this car was built just to cruise. Did notice that the passenger rear tail light was not working. We're gonna need to address that. But as far as the alternator gauge, the gas gauge, temp gauge, and got great oil pressure, all working. Speedometer seems to be intact, right in line, doing 40. That's pretty much what the speed limit is here. I did notice that the Rembo steering wheel is a little hard in spots. The horn is not blowing at this time, so we'll need to check into that, see if it's an issue in the steering wheel or we got an actual issue with the horn. The AC does work, the heater, the wipers work. So we'll need to check into a few of the other things. It does have the original owner's manual and warranty card in the glove box. Right there, David, there's a warranty card and owner's manual. Can hear the stereo trying to play. I'm just gonna turn that off for now. I'm usually not a big fan of green, but this lime green kind of grows on you. You don't see that many in this color. So this kind of a rare color. I actually years ago had a 69 Mach 1 in this color. What was the only other Mustang that I've owned out of the 500 over the years that was this color. It's got decent acceleration. That's what it is for a 302. It's nice to have it all loaded up. Got the upgraded interior with the padded door panels, the wood grain. Actually, the Grande, I believe, is the only other Mustang besides the Mach 1 that you're going to get that the clock and the dash. Magnum 500s, factory air. That works. Blows cold. Do have the seat belts on all five passenger spots. When we get back here in a second, we'll go over the car and point out some of the flaws that we might find or imperfections. Said it's showing 85,537 miles. They're undocumented. That's what's on the speedometer. So this let you know what's on the odometer, I should say. Pressure, got great oil pressure. Temperature's just starting to rise up. It is extremely cold. There's the odometer. And there is the alternator gauge and fuel gauge up top there. Sorry about that. So we'll go around the car. Open the trunk up, please. Point out the wheels look like somebody's put some new wheels and tires. BF Goodrich. Small chip. It's been touched up. There's a little one. Tiny one. Couple small other tiny imperfections. And I'm being picky, just pointing out what we're seeing. A couple other small chips that have been touched up. Small chip there as well. All the chrome trim and the bright work, pretty nice on the vehicle. Another small, two tiny chips there. Again, take a look at the wheels, tires, lug nuts are all in good shape. Small dinks on the drip rail. Dash is really in nice condition. The top, I mean, it's in amazing condition. I almost would have to say somebody at some point put a new one on, because it's just really nice. Another tiny chip. Little patina there, but still shows well. Wheel. A tiny size of a pinhead, little bubble there. Trunk, polyglass style, spare. Appears to be original trunk trim, little minor patina on it. Little imperfection there. Package tray is in great shape. This is the roof and top. Couple tiny chips. somebody put these decal on to break up the lime green. Looks good. You know, these appear to be original. A couple little dinks, a few little scratches in the trim, but still shows well. There's the door jams. A few little scuffs. Door panels are in nice shape. I would, if I was to be a guessing, probably original to the car. Few little wear marks on it. I was gonna say the seat covers, I believe, were had been replaced. They're just in too nice a condition. Front and back appears to be the original rear panels on the car. Rimbo has the typical couple cracks on it, a little bit of wear. People put their thumbs, but overall it's nice. Trunk, car's got a great shine. For more detailed pictures, go to www.westportautocenter.com. We'll have a good description, and like I said, we'll have some detailed pictures of the car for you to look at. If you haven't already done it, please like and share the video. Subscribe to the channel. Help us grow. Oh, the clock is not working. So imagine that. The clock on a Mustang doesn't work. Again, the seats are really nice. It's just a really nice driver. To me, this is a lot of car for the money, especially with the options you're getting. A lot of these cars just came with power steering or maybe power brakes, but it's harder to get these little coupes loaded up, although the Grandes were the high end for the coupe. But with factory air, power brakes, power disc brakes, power steering, nice setup. Hope you enjoyed the video. Again, please like and share, subscribe to the channel. Have a good day.